I'm Ben from Cambridge Audio. We're known for making an amazing range of hi-fi products, but today I'm here to tell you about an invention that we came up with at Cambridge Audio HQ called ATF Audio Upsampling. The aim of a digital music signal is to reproduce the analog sound or waveform made by the singer or instruments. A digital audio signal is created by an analog to digital converter or ADC, which converts an analog signal from a microphone into a digital audio signal. The ADC runs at a set sampling and bit rate. If the aim of a digital signal is to reproduce the analog signal, then the more digital samples we have, the more signal there is, and the closer we are to reproducing that original analog waveform. CD audio, for example, has a sampling rate of 44.1 kHz. That's 44,100 samples every second, whereas the original analog audio is one lovely continuous signal, so effectively has an infinite number of samples per second. So how does upsampling work? The yellow dots represent the samples in a typical digital signal. In this example, there are 6 sample points shown. If this was a CD signal, there would be 44,100 samples every second, or 44,100 yellow dots. When most manufacturers upsample audio, they simply draw a straight line between these given sample points in a digital signal to guess what the original analog audio signal would have looked like. This is known as straight line approximation. When they have their straight line approximation, manufacturers then take their new or upsampled points from that straight line. The green dots represent the new upsampled points. In this example, we've doubled the number of samples. So if this was originally a CD signal, 44.1, this new upsampled signal will have become an 88.2 signal because there are twice as many samples. Straight line approximation works to a certain extent, but we know that audio is a nice smooth curve, not a jagged straight line. So instead of drawing a straight line between the given sample points, like everyone else does, we invented a better way, adaptive time filtering, or ATF upsampling. The ATF system uses an extremely powerful DSP, or digital signal processor, to apply a curve in real time to the audio signal. The ATF system then takes its upsampled points, its green dots, from the curve, rather than from a jagged straight line. When comparing these two examples, both have doubled the number of samples, turning a 44.1 signal into an 88.2 upsampled signal. But the ATF upsampled signal is better because the upsampled points are taken from the curve, which means they're much more representative of the original analog signal that we're trying to reproduce. But we don't stop there. The more snapshots or samples that we take result in a much smoother and more accurate recreation of the original analog waveform because much more information is captured. So whereas a CD only has 44,100 samples every second, the ATF system upsamples to 24-bit 384 kHz, meaning that 384,000 samples are taken every second. Now, as lots of our products can play everything from Spotify and internet radio to high-res FLAC and WAV files, one of the things I often get asked is if everything gets upsampled. The answer is yes. Whichever input the music comes from and whatever its original quality or resolution, ATF upsamples everything to 24384 for the best quality possible. On all products that have it, the ATF upsampling is always on. It can't be switched off or adjusted, because why would you want to? There are 2 big benefits of ATF upsampling. Number 1 is that it provides a really accurate upsampled digital signal, which is actually representative of the original analog signal. Number 2 is that ATF eliminates digital jitter. Jitter is timing errors in the audio signal and is really bad for audio because our ears are very sensitive to these timing errors. So it's vital that we get rid of it. So, wherever your music comes from and whatever its original quality or resolution, ATF upsamples and cleans it up, providing a high quality, low distortion audio signal and ultimately better sound.